Hello and welcome to a new episode of Man Cave Printing. I recently upgraded my camera setup with a DSLR camera like this, a Canon EOS 700D, so I can do my videos in better quality. Also, it has a display that points towards me so I can see myself while filming, so this is a big pro. I thought this setup could also improve the time-lapse Tuesday with better video quality. I did some research online and I found an easy way to put this DSLR camera with only the help of a little endstop and an aux cable to work as time-lapse camera only with octolapse on the Raspberry Pi. It is quite easy how it works. The Canon EOS camera has an aux port right here, so you can put your cable in here and the camera can be focused via the aux cable or even be triggered via the aux cable. So what is special about the cable is it is not the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, it is a 2.5 millimeter jack, so you might need to buy a new one. Also, you might want to use a cable you don't need anymore because you have to cut it in half, as you can see here. The build of the setup is pretty easy. This will be done in the next step. To build the setup, you obviously need the DSLR camera. Also, you need your aux cable, which you cut in half. You need a simple endstop like it is installed in your printer. And also, you need a custom mount. This one I already printed out. It is orientated on the normal y-axis end stop on the Ender 5. In the first step, you need to strip these cable ends, and after that you will find four single wires in there, and after that we can go on testing which strips do which function. Now, after you strip the cables, you can see in each wire here there is one also insulated cable. I hope you can see it. And also one not insulated cable. To find out which one we need, we just have to plug the other end of the cable into the camera and short these connections. So let's try this out. Turn on the camera. Here you can see the display. So now that we got the cable plugged in, we can test with our wires. So we can test the not insulated wires together, the insulated wires together, or crossover. So I will test the insulated wires together first, and that is also the right combination now. So the green and the white wire trigger the camera, and so we know which cables we have to focus on. So we can cut off the non-insulated wires. Now we got the cables we need. And if you want to, you can now solder some extra cable in between. So you got a longer trigger cable because this is only like 30 or 40 centimeters long. Let's do this right now, real quick. I already prepared something. As you can see here, I got an extra long cable, so I put my camera far away enough from my printer. And now we have to take a closer look on the endstop. So we got this little cheap endstop for like 30 cents on here. And what we have to take a closer look is the description on the endstop. I hope it focuses now. So I think you can't see it right here, but every pin has a description on it. It reads NC, NO, and C. So the NC stands for normally closed and the NO stands for normally open. And for our triggering, we want to use the normally open because when we press the end stop, it connects the white and the green wire and triggers the camera. I also prepared this, so we just solder our two pins on here. And after we did this, we can again plug in our cable into the camera right here. So now after we put everything together, we can try it out. If we press the end stop, it triggers the camera and we get a picture every time we want. So I wanted every layer, so I have to activate my octolapse to drive to the back of the print bed every single layer. So let's install this on the printer on the last step. After the install is done, everything looks like this. And now you can take a look if it works out. So you just move your axis manually against it and you hear double clicking, so the position is at the optimum. We trigger the end stop and the camera trigger at once. So here is the end stop and here is the camera trigger, and we drive against it and hit it at once. And now with the camera attached, we can test it again. So we drive against it and the camera takes a photo. Every time we drive against it, it works like a charm. So this is pretty it for the setup. Now you just have to go into your octoprint and activate octolapse and have to tell it so it has to drive backwards every time you want to take a photo, or to the front if you install it on the opposite side. And I will do some test with it and show you a time lapse right now. So have fun. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions about the setup or any comments, let me know down under the video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and give it a like. Also, if you like to see videos in German, tell me in the comments so I can do subtitles for every video or even film them in German. Have a nice day and see you the next time. Goodbye.